गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. वी वर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर 10 रीचिंग द एज ऑफ एडोलेसेंस. सो फार वी हैव डिस्कस दैट एडोलेसेंस इज दैट पीरियड ऑफ लाइफ व्हेन बॉडी अंडरगोस सेवरल चेंजेस लीडिंग टू रिप्रोडक्टिव मैच्योरिटी. ठीक है, ये हमारी लाइफ का वो पीरियड होता है जब हमारी बॉडी सेक्सुअली मैच्योर हो जाती है एंड द बॉयज एंड गर्ल देयर रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स बिकम फंक्शनल एंड दे बिकम कैपेबल ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. And we have discussed the changes which take place during the adolescence. There are several changes which occur during the age of adolescence. This age begins from the age of 11. The period of adolescence, it begins from the age of 11 and it lasts up to 18 or 19 years in boys and girls. Several changes take place during the this period of adolescence, or you can say puberty. So puberty is marked by these changes, and these changes are like sudden increase in the height. We have discussed that changes during puberty stages, changes that take place during puberty adolescence, or you can say puberty stage, these are sudden increase in height, change in body shape, changing voice, change in voice. There is change in the voice of boys and girls. Boys, their voice become deep and harsh. On the other hand, the girls, their voice is high pitch. These changes in detail we have discussed in the previous video. So here I am just writing those changes. And explanation already I have done in the previous video. Increased activity of sweat and sebaceous gland. Sebaceous, the word sebaceous is for oil gland, right? So, it is the activity of sweat and sebaceous, or you can say oil gland. Other changes also you will observe, like development of sex organs and appearance of secondary sexual characteristics is also there. So, here I can write development of sex organs. This is the primary change that will take place. Sex organs, they get fully developed. And in male, testes, they start releasing sperm. And in female, ovaries, they start releasing ovum. Right? So, development of sex organs. We have also discussed that at this stage, the body, it become mentally, intellectually and emotionally mature. The boys and girls in the age of this age of adolescent, they start thinking intelligently, and there is intellectual development. Emotionally they start developing, and in this way you can see many changes which are taking place during the period of adolescence. Now we will talk a little about secondary sexual characters. During this stage, secondary sexual characters can be seen which distinguish a male from a female. For these secondary sexual characters, secondary sexual characters during the age of adolescence, during the period of adolescence, secondary sexual characters can be seen in male and female. These are the characters which distinguish a male from female. Right? Like, let us talk about these secondary sexual characters. Like moustache and beard in the case of boys, and development of breast in case of girls. So we can distinguish boys from girl by these physical change in the physical appearance of boys and girl. You can see facial hair in case of boys, and we can easily distinguish a boy from girl with the help of these secondary sexual characters. Right? Now the changes which occur at adolescence, these are controlled by hormones. Changes that occur at adolescence are controlled by hormones. Now the question is, what are hormones? Hormones are the chemical substance. Hormones are the chemical substance which are secreted by endocrine gland. So, अभी हमने देखा कि जो changes adolescence period में हो रहे हैं उनके लिए hormones responsible हैं, और ये hormones जो gland secrete करती हैं हम उन्हें endocrine glands कहते हैं. So, hormones are the chemicals secreted by endocrine glands. So, here I have used the word endocrine. Endocrine glands secretes chemical which we called hormones, right? And the endocrine glands, they are also called ductless gland. Ductless gland. These are without duct. कोई ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इनमें नहीं होता. दे डायरेक्टली पोर देयर सिक्रीशन इनटू ब्लड स्ट्रीम. देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ ग्लैंड्स इन आवर बॉडी. हमारी बॉडी में टू टाइप्स की ग्लैंड है, एक्सोक्राइन ग्लैंड एंड एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड. एक्सोक्राइन ग्लैंड दे पोर देयर सिक्रीशन थ्रू डक्ट. उनमें डक्ट होती है, डक्ट इज देयर. एंड एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स these are ductless. Exocrine gland like sweat gland, like oil gland, right? And like salivary gland, these are the glands which pour their secretion through the duct. They have duct through which their secretion is transported. While in endocrine gland there is no duct, they directly pour their secretion into blood stream, and through blood the hormone, it reaches the particular organ, or you can say cell. In this way, endocrine glands, they secrete hormones, and these hormones through blood reaches their target site. Now here I am using the word target site. What is target site? It is that particular part where the hormone has to reach, and it reach there through the blood. And that particular site, that particular point where the hormone reach and stimulates changes, then that is called target site. उस particular point को हम target site कहते हैं जहाँ hormone changes को initiate करते हैं. ठीक है? So इस तरह हम देखते हैं कि हमारी body में two types की gland है, और जो ductless gland है उन्हें हम endocrine glands कहते हैं. ये कुछ chemicals secrete करते हैं जिन्हें हम hormones कहते हैं, and hormones are responsible for the changes which are taking place during adolescence. Now the next point which I am going to discuss, that for the secondary sexual characters, there are two sex hormones which are responsible for secondary sexual character. These are testosterone in male. Testosterone is secreted by testes in male, and estrogen, progesterone and estrogen, these are the hormones secreted by ovaries in female. And these hormones are responsible for secondary and primary sexual characters that will take place in the boy and girl during the adolescence period. Testosterone जो changes boys में आएंगे at the period of adolescence उनके लिए responsible होगा, और estrogen जो sex hormone है, these both are sex hormones, these two are sex hormones. और हमारी ovaries और testes जो ये hormones secrete करती हैं, इसके लिए भी पहले से जो एक और gland है, that is pituitary gland. Pituitary gland secrete some hormone. Actually, it is GTH, gonadotropic hormone. Pituitary gland, it secrete a hormone, and this hormone stimulate testes and ovaries to secrete testosterone and estrogen respectively. ठीक है, testes और ovaries ये hormone release करती हैं, लेकिन कब release करती हैं? जब pituitary gland का hormone जो है उन्हें stimulate करता है. So during the period of adolescence, pituitary gland release a hormone. मैंने भी नाम बताया, GTH, गोनेडोट्रॉपिक हार्मोन होता है ये. एंड दिस हार्मोन टारगेट साइड उसकी क्या है? टेस्टिस इन मेल एंड ओवरीज इन फीमेल. सो थ्रू ब्लड इट रीचेस टेस्टिस इन मेल एंड ओवरीज इन फीमेल, एंड देयर दिस हार्मोन स्टिमुलेट टेस्टिस टू रिलीज टेस्टोस्टेरोन एंड ओवरीज टू रिलीज ईस्ट्रोजन, राइट? एंड नाउ दीज हार्मोन्स these are released by testes, and now they stimulate the changes which take place at the onset of puberty. So in this way, changes take place at the onset of puberty by the, it is controlled by the hormones. I hope ये जो topic है आपको clear हो गया कि जो glands hormones secrete कर रही हैं उसी के control में ये जो changes हो रहे हैं puberty stage में, they are just because of those hormones, right? Now the next topic which we are going to discuss is reproductive phase of life in human. Reproductive phase of life in humans. Now, हमें पता है adolescent is that period when body become capable of reproduction, right? When the testes and ovaries they begin to produce gametes. Testes और ovaries gametes produce करने लगते हैं during this adolescent period, right? And now the thing is there, the capacity for maturation and production of gamete lasts for a much longer time in males than in females. जो रिप्रोडक्टिव फेज है वो मेल में लंबे समय तक होता है, जबकि फीमेल का जो रिप्रोडक्टिव फेज है एज कंपेयर टू मेल वो शॉर्ट है. ठीक है, फीमेल हमें पता है उनका जो रिप्रोडक्टिव फेज है वो 10 टू 12 इयर्स की एज से स्टार्ट हो जाता है, एंड इट लास्ट टिल द एज ऑफ 45 टू 50 ईयर की एज तक आते आते फीमेल में रिप्रोडक्टिव फेज स्टॉप हो जाता है. मीन्स 45 या 50 मैक्सिमम 50 एज तक फीमेल जो है वो रिप्रोडक्टिव रहती हैं, उसके बाद एग प्रोड्यूस होना बंद हो जाता है ओवरीज से, राइट? जबकि मेल में इट लास्ट फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम. नाउ व्हाट हैपन देयर, एवरी मंथ वन ओवरी रिलीज वन ओवम. देयर आर टू ओवरीज इन फीमेल, और यू कैन से अ पेयर ऑफ ओवरीज इन फीमेल, और हर आफ्टर एवरी 28 और 30 डेज वन ओवम इज रिलीज बाय वन ओवरी. सो एवरी मंथ वन एग इज रिलीज बाय द ओवरीज, एंड एट दिस पीरियड व्हाट हैपन, यूट्रिन वॉल इट बिकम थिकन, स्टार्ट बिकमिंग थिक. सो इफ द एग इज नॉट फर्टिलाइज, then what happens, this uterine wall along with the blood vessel it shed off and it comes out of the woman body along with the blood, and this bleeding is called menstruation. What do we call this bleeding? Menstruation. The first menstrual flow, which begins at the age of puberty, is called menarche. In the girls, when the first menstrual flow begins, then we call it menarche. And we are aware now that reproductive phase of female is limited. It is up to the age of 45 or 50 years. So menstruation, it lasts up to the age of 45 or 50 years. So when the last, when there is a stoppage of menstruation, we call it menopause. The stage when the female, they do not undergo menstruation cycle, we call it menopause. So what is menopause? So it is the beginning of menstruation, and menopause is stoppage of menstruation. Stoppage of menstruation. Stoppage of menstruation. So I hope ये आपको समझ आ गया. Let me explain again. Like menstrual cycle, it is controlled by hormones. ये जो menstrual cycle है, इसे hormones control करते हैं. This cycle include, ये जो menstrual cycle है, it includes maturing of egg, right? Egg get mature and it is released by the ovaries. Then thickening of uterine wall. Uterine wall it get thicker. It break down if pregnancy does not occur. In case the egg is fertilized, it divides, redivides, and this embryo get embedded in the uterus for further development. So this all you have learnt in chapter 9, that how embryo develops in the uterus. ये तो आपने chapter 9 में reproduction में पढ़ा ही था. ये अगर egg fertilized हो जाता है तो इट डिवाइड्स, रीडिवाइड्स एंड फाइनली एम्ब्रियो इट गेट्स एम्बेडेड इन द यूट्रस. एंड इन केस फर्टिलाइजेशन डज नॉट टेक प्लेस, देन द यूट्रेन वॉल, थिकनिंग ऑफ द यूट्रेन वॉल एंड ब्लड वेसल, दे गेट शेड ऑफ एंड दिस फ्लो ऑफ ब्लड इज कॉल्ड मेंस्ट्रुएशन. इट अकर्स एवरी मंथ और यू कैन से आफ्टर एवरी 28 डेज इन फीमेल्स, इन गर्ल्स, राइट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज हाउ इज द सेक्स ऑफ बेबी डिटरमाइंड. How is the sex of the baby determined? Whether a zygote develops into a boy or a girl, what determines that? एक जयगोट एक बॉय में डेवलप होगा या एक गर्ल में, वो क्या चीज़ है जो डिटरमाइन करती है सेक्स ऑफ द बेबी. सो देयर आर इंस्ट्रक्शन इन द जायगोट, देयर आर थ्रेड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इन आर न्यूक्लियस विच वी कॉल क्रोमोसोम्स. सो क्रोमोसोम्स विच कंटेन जेनेटिक मटेरियल, दे हैव द इंस्ट्रक्शन वेदर द जायगोट विल डेवलप इन टू अ बॉय और अ गर्ल. तो हमारा जो हर सेल है, इन आवर एवरी सेल देयर आर 23 पेयर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स. इन द न्यूक्लियस, इन द न्यूक्लियस ऑफ आवर सेल देयर आर 23 पेयर्स ऑफ क्रोमोसोम इन ह्यूमन बींग्स. इन ह्यूमन बींग्स देयर आर 23 पेयर्स ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स इन ईच न्यूक्लियाई ऑफ ईच सेल. एवरी सेल, हर सेल के न्यूक्लियस में 23 पेयर्स ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स होते हैं. आउट ऑफ दीज 23 पेयर्स ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स, टू क्रोमोसोम, और यू कैन से वन पेयर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम इज सेक्स क्रोमोसोम. सो देयर आर टू क्रोमोसोम्स दैट डिटरमाइन द सेक्स, दे आर कॉल्ड टू सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स. सेक्स डिटरमाइनिंग क्रोमोसोम्स आर कॉल्ड सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स, राइट. तो जो जायगोट फॉर्म होता है उसमें सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स होते हैं, दैट डिटरमाइन द सेक्स ऑफ द बेबी. नाउ द सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स, वी आर अवेयर देयर आर टू क्रोमोसोम्स व्हिच वी कॉल सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स. आउट ऑफ 23 पेयर्स, 22 पेयर ऑफ द क्रोमोसोम्स दे आर कॉल्ड ऑटोसोम्स. 23 में से 22 पेयर्स जो हैं उन क्रोमोसोम्स को हम ऑटोसोम्स कहते हैं. 22 पेयर्स they are called autosomes, and one pair or you can say two chromosomes they are called sex chromosomes. and we have given them name X and Y. X and Y. There are two types of sex chromosome, X and Y. In the nucleus of female, there is only X chromosomes. So there are two X chromosomes in each nuclei of the female. And in case of male, there are X and Y sex chromosomes. We know that gametes are haploid. We are aware that gametes are haploid. Gametes are haploid. They have only one set of chromosomes. So, in a sperm, there can be X chromosome or there can be Y sex chromosomes. On the other hand, egg, they always have X chromosomes. So, gametes are haploid. These are the sperm. And this is ovum. Sperm, it can be of two type, X type and Y type. But ovum is always of X type. Means there is only X sex chromosome in egg. And there can be X sex chromosome or Y sex chromosome in sperm. So, the sperm, the type of sperm which fuses with the egg will determine the sex of the baby. If Y sex chromosome having sperm will fertilize the egg, then the zygote will have XY chromosomes, XY set of chromosome, and this zygote will develop into a boy. If X sperm fuses with X ovum, then zygote will have XX type set of chromosome, and this zygote will develop into a girl. So student, I hope now it is clear that it is the type of sperm which is responsible for determining the sex of a baby. The type of sperm that fuses with the egg, it is responsible for the sex of the baby. So female, they are not responsible for the sex of the baby. It is the sperm that fertilizes the egg which will determine the sex of the baby. I hope this topic is clear to you. Now the next topic is hormones other than sex hormones. Hormones. Other than sex hormones. So, we have discussed that there are two sex hormones. We have talked about two sex hormones, testosterone and estrogen in female, testosterone in male. Now, we will talk about some more hormones secreted by the glands like pituitary gland. Pituitary gland. This gland is also called master gland, because this gland secrete the hormones which controls other glands also, secretion of other glands also. Pituitary gland ko master gland kaha gaya hai, kyunki ye dusri glands ki secretion ko bhi initiate karti hai, control karti hai. So it is called master gland. Pituitary gland, it secretes growth hormone, GH, responsible for the growth. It also secretes GTH, gonadotropic hormone. It also secretes TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone. It also secretes FSH, follicle stimulating hormone. So in this way, this gland secretes many hormones which initiate, or which you can say stimulates the secretion of other glands also. So in this way, this gland is called master gland. So if anyone asks you the hormones secreted by pituitary gland, you can tell them growth hormone, gonadotropic hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, follicle stimulating hormone. So pituitary gland secrete many hormones. This is the master gland, and it is situated in our brain. Right. Now the next gland which we are going to talk about is thyroid gland. Thyroid gland. This gland secretes thyroxine. Thyroxine controls growth and metabolism of our body. हमारी body metabolism को, growth को thyroxine hormone control करता है. And iodine is essential for the formation of thyroxine. आपने junior classes में भी पढ़ा है कि if our thyroid gland does not function properly, if there is lack of thyroxine, then the disease like goiter will take place. Goiter means bulging of thyroid gland. That situation is called goiter. और इसके लिए we should eat iodized salt so that our thyroid gland can function properly. So I hope this is clear to you that thyroid gland secrete thyroxine which is responsible for growth and many metabolism, proper functioning of the metabolism of our body. Right? Now the next hormone is adrenal gland. It secretes adrenaline. Adrenal glands, thyroid glands की location हमारा neck region है और इसके बाद जो adrenal gland है, there are a pair of adrenal gland. These glands are located on our kidneys. The adrenal gland secretes the hormone adrenaline. The hormone adrenaline help our body to fight with stress. ये हार्मोन बॉडी को स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन से डील करने किस तरह से डील किया जाना चाहिए उसमें हेल्प करते हैं. दे हेल्प टू डील अस विद द स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन लाइक वॉरीज और एनी एंग्जाइटी और एंगर. व्हेन वी आर इन एनी सिचुएशन, व्हेन वी आर वेरी एंग्री, व्हेन वी आर वेरी वरीड, देन दिस हार्मोन एड्रेनालिन हेल्प अस टू फेस सच स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन. And now the next hormone which I am going to talk is testes. They secrete testosterone. Testosterone is responsible for the primary and secondary sexual characteristics in male. And ovaries, they secrete estrogen and progesterone. These sex hormones are responsible for primary and secondary sexual characteristics, right? Now, we will talk about role of hormones. Role of hormone in completing the life history of insect and frog. In completing the life history of insect and frogs. In the chapter 9 reproduction we have discussed metamorphosis. हमने metamorphosis discuss किया था that the transformation of larva into adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. इस metamorphosis हमने देखा कि insect की जो life cycle है उसमें different stages आती है. When the egg is hatched and young ones come out, it does not resemble the adult. It undergoes many drastic changes to become an adult. जैसे हमने frog के केस में देखा था कि tadpole frog से बहुत different होता है and it undergoes several changes which we call metamorphosis. इसी तरह से insect में caterpillar जिसको हम larval stage कहते हैं, उसके बाद pupa and then it changes into adult. So many drastic changes will take place and we call this metamorphosis. So hormones are responsible here for this metamorphosis, for these changes. Hormones are responsible, hormones are required. अगर हम frog की बात करें, in case of frog, metamorphosis occur with the help of the hormone thyroxine. Thyroxine Thyroxine in frog. Help in metamorphosis. And this thyroxine hormone is released by thyroid gland, and for the formation of thyroxine, iodine is essential. So the pond where the tadpole are there, that water must have iodine in it. Otherwise, tadpole, they cannot transform into adult. Metamorphosis cannot take place without thyroxine. And thyroxine will be produced only with the help of iodine. So the pond water, it should have iodine. It must have iodine. Only then a tadpole can transform into adult form. I hope this is clear to you. Now we will talk about the insect. For the completion of the life cycle of an insect, for the metamorphosis you can say, insect hormone is required. The hormone responsible for metamorphosis in insect is called insect hormone. So, now we come to know that there is role of hormone also in completing the life history of insect and frog. Now we will talk about the reproductive health. Reproductive health. So, student, the physical and mental well-being of an individual is regarded as an individual health. To keep the body healthy, every human being at any age need to have a balanced diet. So, what are the things required for being healthy? So, we are aware that we are the adolescents, their body is undergoing many changes leading to the reproductive maturity, right? And so, they should be more concerned about their health as their body is undergoing many changes. So what should be done during the period of adolescence? Balanced diet. To maintain a good reproductive health, balanced diet is required. We are also aware that at the time of adolescence, sweat gland and oil gland, they become very active. As a result, the boys and girls, they face acne and pimples on their face. So as the sweat gland and oil gland are very active, so it become very essential that we should take bath regularly during this period. So personal hygiene is of prime importance during the stage of adolescence. Right. And the third is physical exercise. So, for the proper health, for a good health, these three things are very important. And fourth one, you can say no to drugs. So, an adolescent, he must be very careful regarding his diet. He should take proper balanced diet. A diet that contains all the nutrients in proper amount is called balanced diet. So the diet having carbohydrates, fats, proteins and vitamins, minerals, it is called a balanced diet. So we must have a good healthy diet during the period of adolescence as our body is undergoing many changes during this period. Personal hygiene should be taken care for so that our body can remain free from the disease. Physical exercise is essential for each and every one of us. So for a good health, we should do physical exercise, and drugs should not be taken because we become addictive to drug. When we take drugs, we become addictive, and we have drugs, they causes many harm to our body. So we should not take drugs if you want a good health. You might have heard about a disease called AIDS. So, AIDS, which is caused by HIV virus, right? AIDS, the full form of AIDS is acquired नो डेफिशिएंसी सिंड्रोम. So, it's the full form of AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, and this is human immunovirus which causes the disease, HIV virus, human immunovirus, which is responsible for the AIDS. And we are aware that this disease is also spread by using infective syringe. Sometimes the young generation, they take drugs with the syringe and they exchange these syringe with each other. And syringes, this AIDS, HIV virus can spread through infected syringes also. So there are more chances of disease like AIDS in case the people, they are taking drugs through the syringe. Youngster, if they are taking drugs through syringe and they are exchanges this syringe, then they might have danger of AIDS also at more larger pace, you can say. ज़्यादा chances हो जाते हैं AIDS होने के इन youngsters को. So we should be careful regarding this, and if we want good health, we should say no to drugs. So this was all in the chapter. Chapter was very easy. I hope you all understood the chapter. Still, if you have any doubt, you are free to ask in your doubt class. So till then, bye. Okay, take care, stay safe, stay home.